This episode was sponsored by Dropbox. A murder of crows. An appropriate name considering these birds' special relationship with death. It's not because they're killers, or because they'll sometimes scavenge the bodies of the recently departed. When one of their own dies, crows will surround and call to the dead. In one experiment, scientists holding taxidermied birds approached crows and were viciously attacked. Of course, the creepy masks didn't help. Crows hold funerals, which also explains the black clothing.
And now his watch has ended.
We also congregate around those we've lost to remember them, to console each other in times of sadness and in grief. But are we the only creatures who experience these emotions? Do animals mourn their dead? Dying is a fact of life. It's true for everything that's ever been born. And it's not a pretty thought.
After you die, your cells burst open, insects lay eggs in your body, and bacteria turn you into a putrefaction soup.
Thanks, Anna. That was gross. Being intelligent means that we understand a lot about how death happens, not to mention that it will one day happen to us.
Thinking about mortality can influence our behavior. Humans are curious, anxious, and even frightened about death. A side effect of our intelligence is that we can picture the future, and ourselves and our loved ones won't be a part of it.
Well, that's a cheery thought, Vanessa. For a long time, scientists assumed that grief was unique to humans, but observing certain animals is making us think again. Eleanor was an elephant. Sick and injured, she fell behind her herd and collapsed. Scientists watched as another elephant named Grace ran to her side and tried to lift her up. Sadly, she couldn't. Eleanor died. Over the next several days, her body was visited by 5 different groups of elephants, some completely unrelated to her. They circled the body, caressing it with their feet and trunks, never out of sight, even when lions and hyenas moved in. That's a sad story. To us, anyway. Scientists agree that animals have emotions, but forcing human experiences upon them is anthropomorphism. When elephants and crows hold funerals, are we forcing human emotions onto the lives of animals, or are they truly experiencing grief? Animal researcher Barbara J. King says that grief is a change in an animal's behavior in response to death. They might shift their daily routines, adopt different body language, eat or sleep less, or even put themselves in greater danger to predators. It seems that the elephants were grieving.
Other intelligent animals experience grief in similar ways. Entire troops of chimpanzees will gather around and protect their dead. Mothers will even carry lifeless infants around for days or weeks.
Scientists also noticed a group of dolphins gathering around a dead calf, refusing to eat for days and guarding the body even after it started to decay.
Many scientists are now certain that grieving isn't something that we do and animals don't. It's just that ours is more complex. There are many things that humans do that are unique among animals, but many things aren't. Projecting our emotions onto other creatures is a bad habit, but we can be sure that animals have emotions of their own. These animals are deeply moved by grief. Some, like the crows, may use their death rituals to learn about death, but for others, there seems to be something more. Many animals are social. They develop relationships and experience positive emotions from their families and friends. Maybe not happiness or love, but something. Animal mourning might stem from these memories, from realizing what is missing. And we can all relate to that. Stay curious. Follow me over to BrainCraft to find out some surprising ways that death can affect the minds of the living. And assuming you haven't eaten recently, join me over on Gross Science, and we'll find out how some of life's tiniest critters can crack open big mysteries about death. This episode was sponsored by Dropbox. No matter what you create, whether you write it, draw it, mix it, or test it, Dropbox makes it simple to work the way that you want. That's why over 400 million people around the world use Dropbox to work together on any file with anyone from anywhere. Dropbox, all yours.
Thank you.
Ted Williams said the hardest thing to do in a sport is hit a baseball.
I think he was right.